Hello, good evening. My name is Etelvon Okonama. I am a fish farmer. I'm a consultant in fish farming. I am also the secretary of National Fish Association of Nigeria, Akwa Ibom State Chapter, NFA. The prospects and challenges of small-scale fish farming. The prospects include, number one, experience gathering. You gather experience as a small-scale farmer. Number two, market acquaintance. You acquaint yourself with the market strategies, marketing of your fish farming, and so on, since you are small. Number three, controlling the fish. For instance, when there's disease outbreak, you can easily control them since they are small. Number four, minimizing risk. Number five, minimizing loss. Number six, making sure that you mobility. Yes, for instance, like this tarpaulin pond you are seeing here, it's mobile. This is the back of my house, for instance. This is back of my own compound in the house. And I'm able to install this because I know I can move away from here anytime in case this is not my house. What are the challenges of this small scale farming? One of it is that you may not make enough profit to go around. But don't be dismayed. Since you have experience, you can expand and make more profit. Like other businesses, the more you invest, the more you make profit. Number two, the challenges is that if you don't have the technical know-how, then it is going to be at a loss to you. Number three, one of the challenges is that you need to be able to strategize and be able to. It takes time. It gives you time. You're going to have a lot of time to be able to develop yourself into an expert in the industry. Number four, the challenges you are looking at in a small-scale fish farming, is that you may not be able to contribute high quota into the fish industry in Nigeria. But as you're looking at it, the advantage or the prospect actually outweigh the challenges. I encourage people, when you are doing your fish farming, you can start small if you don't have the necessary technical know-how, or you can engage consultants, engage experts, or engage people who are also in the industry for a very long time, look at them and use them as a model in developing your fish farming skill. Then you can start small. There's no crime in starting small at the back of your house, at the veranda, at anywhere you want to start. Just start small. You can control your fish. Like I say, one of the advantages is that if there is loss, it's minimal. If there's risk, it's minimal. If there's any disaster or flood, it won't come near you because what you have is still small. It's movable, like this tarpaulin pond here. It's very movable. I can move it from here to somewhere else and so on. So here is my advice. You can actually start small, but don't be in a hurry to make big profit. Start small, gather experience, and become a voice in the